I'm going to work on the accent. So sekarang ni the problem with people is they don't know how to start.
Betul.
Everything. Yeah. So start slow. Set a very small goals. You know, start macam the last minute, 20 minit, and then at the same time kita like, we Malaysian people, we love to eat. You know, there's a lot of good people, good food and everything. So makan tu roti canai, nasi lemak, breakfast and everything. So the fats is gonna store in your body. So how actually when you're burning? By exercising. Like it's not exercise when you jalan walk in the park or you know just swim or anything. As long as it is active, then you can do it. Yeah.
Kita rasa kita makan kepada weight loss. Wahai, kalau korang nak fat loss, can you receive what I advise is 1,600. Kenapa tinggi? Because when it comes to fat loss, you cuma fokus kepada fat. So to decrease fat percentage in your body, you need a little bit of muscle. The more muscle you have, the less fat you have in your body. So, contoh, katakan dulu, my own experience, masa sebelum I get into fitness, I was 42 kilo. Right now, I'm 55 kilo. There's a huge gap there, 42 and 55. But last time, when I first started fitness, my body fat percentage is way higher than now. I need to put on a little bit of lean muscle mass to decrease my fat in the body.
Yeah.
Okay? So the less muscle you have, the more fat you store. Sebab tu adanya term gemuk kurus. Pernah dengar tak term ni? Dia kurus tapi fat percentage dia tinggi.
Itu saya.
Kata you are like, hello, I knew you before, I knew you can do everything. So you're okay. So, gemuk kurus ni dikatakan walaupun macam katalah contoh you kurus, you 40 kilo tapi you ada macam-macam diabetes, you ada hypertension, lepas tu kandungan lemak dalam badan you kena tindak almost reach obesity. Betul tak?
Yeah, betul.
You wanna eat anything about this?
So, macam orang selalu like, okay, this is just want to share my experience lah. A lot of my client datang my center memang dia akan, before we start the exercise, kita akan buat body analysis. What is actually body analysis is how we check dia punya fat percentage and dia punya muscle mass to determine how can we change. It's actually like a guideline and also baseline. Where should you start dia punya apa tu exercise and how we can advise them apa tu on diet wise. So memang data ni semua memang all very skinny. Kalau kita tengok pun, oh my god, she look perfect. Like memang model type and everything, yes. But then bila dia buat body analysis, you can see that memang exceed
the borderline,
or the borderline
obese, or like exceed sikit obese. Tapi kita tak tahu.
Exactly. Lepas tu dia tengok, oh my god, but I'm very skinny, what is this? So that's how when the education I can start, so we can actually advise to her that basically memang dia basically back to yang jaga makan sahaja, exercise kurang. So it can, bila juga ada lemak yang banyak, dia punya mass sangat rendah, that's what we call skinny fat lah.
Skinny fat?
Yes, in bahasa Englishnya. Tapi bahasa Melayu gemuk kurus. So macam dia confused pula, gemuk kurus apa benda ni? So it's actually skinny fat lah. So back to that point, and then
so once you implement apa you punya fitness goal, you dah tanya you nak weight loss or fat loss. Lepas tu tanya diri sendiri, what are you ready to commit? Kalau macam you nak turunkan your body, ada shape here and there, tuck in here and there, basically macam orang kata apa, sculpting your body.
Yes.
Then you have to be prepared to undergo strength training, nombor satu, strength training, a little bit of cardio, and pemakanan you is not 70%. Apa yang dengar kat social media, dekat TV, 70-30, that is nonsense. There's no such thing as 70-30. It's always 100% food.
Yes.
But if you want to tone your body, sometimes it can go up to 120% food. Why I say 120%? Because you cannot slack at all. If you slack, memang susah nak dapat. Pernah tak korang tengok orang pergi gym 4, 5, 6 tahun, 10 tahun, 12 tahun, tak cari-cari pun. Sebab apa? Why? Because the food ke laut. Cakap dengan trainer, dengan coach, I diet, I diet. Tapi kan kawan-kawan kat belakang cakap, ala kan lupa pasal tu tak apalah. Ala sikit je. Tak ada. There's no such thing as sikit-sikit.
Dia cakap bulking.
Bulking forever.
Forever.
So, you have to set your mind. But kalau you rasa macam you nak buat weight loss, tak kira lah kalori itu macam mana, apa you makan, asalkan kalori itu deficit.
Yep.
Okay, sebagai contoh, I nak kena explain perbezaan di antara sepinggan orang kata apa dish yang 300 kalori tapi healthy dan sepinggan dish yang tak healthy.
Okay, so basically kalau kita cakap about healthy food kan, healthy lah ni kan. Basically you got ada single income nasi, and then you got like about half of chicken breast macam tu. So kalau bakteri ni orang semua akan fikir, oh makan macam western lah, chicken grill, you know. Lepas tu nak makan kena masak bakar dengan steam. It doesn't necessarily have to be like that. You still boleh makan layu. It's just that how what you put into your dish. So basically kurangkan more on the gula and also garam.
Yeah.
Of course it's gonna taste less sedap, but this is where you start on something. That's why back to the Nana cakap, set a small goal first. Set a very realistic goal. You start with the rak nasi. Nasi is not your enemy. You still can eat. So makan nasi, maybe ayam or ikan. Depends what you want to eat, and then ada apa tu veggies.
Veggies is really important.
Yes, you need to eat your green. This is healthy plate that we're talking. Now we move on to the unhealthy punya dish. Segekam burger. Itu sahaja.
Okay.
Yes. Burger dah banyak. So, can you see, imagine, kalau you makan slice cake, you rasa kenyang tak? Kenyang ke tak? Memang akan makan dua or tiga kan, at least kan? So, if you makan nasi and everything, definitely can cover like up to 4 to 5 hours. Yeah, so that's the difference.
And to add on that, katakanlah, okay, this two comparison, right? Sepingkan nasi with a bit of protein, fiber and healthy fats. And sepotong cake yang 300 calorie contoh. So weight loss, orang boleh makan this potong cake, but what kind of nutrients that you will get is all refined sugar, carbohydrates, and benda-benda yang boleh memburukkan apa kesihatan you. What I have kat sini, it refuel and nourish your, I would say, health and body recovery with apa workout dan sebagainya. Sebab makanan masa ni adalah protein. Your body need good fats to actually function. Kalau you tak ambil good fats seperti fish oil dan sebagainya, itulah yang lutut you berbunyi, joint you start sakit-sakit, your brain cannot function properly, and carbohydrates is simply just to make you happy. Our body don't really need carbohydrates to function. But why carbohydrates is so important? Because it controls our hormones. It contributes to us to be more happy. Katalah orang yang buat keto diet, contoh punya anak dengar berdiet, lepas tu kan
Ada gelap,
dia sebenarnya macam, oh my god, I can only makan ni sahaja. Cukup 2 bulan, kau tengok bos kau kena marah, rasa nak kapal je, betul tak? Sebab why there's no carbohydrates, no sugar inside. Kan lepas tu, once you stop keto diet, you back to like, you know, eating rampage. Lepas tu, you naik balik. Sebab
tu, carbohydrates
and sugar makes you happy. Carbs is sugar. So it has to be a balanced diet whereby you have to determine what is your fitness goal, and dah setelah nak fat loss or weight loss, and then tanya diri sendiri whether you are ready to commit to your diet. If you tak ready, then do pelan-pelan.
Slow-slow. Cut slow-slow, makan probably nasi to you. Cut small portion ke, because doesn't necessarily tak boleh nasi dan everything, you know, and then apa tu, apa tu ayam dan everything. Kalau rasa still nak makan juga berkuah-kuah, kurangkan sikit je. Boleh je, start small and then eventually you'll get it. Yeah.
And last but not least, after you dah plan everything, always take your orang kata apa macam your progress photos, so that you have, you know, motivation to continuously motivate yourself. Motivation doesn't come from me, doesn't come from mine, doesn't come from your fitness videos or whatsoever. It comes from you. You can watch YouTube videos berpuluh-puluh ribu dekat YouTube. Tapi kalau diri sendiri macam malas, itu memang tak boleh tolonglah, sebab penyakit malas ni nobody can help. Motivation comes from yourself.
Yes.
That's why it has to be a lifestyle. It has to come from you, not any of us. We can only encourage and inspire. Okay, we have 4 minutes. Probably we can open any question to all of you to ask us any questions. Yes!
Student gym lah.
Semua kita tanya tau. Bagus.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
That's
very good.
That's the spirit.
Anyway, kita cuba hanya I will play together, okay?
Dia pregnant.
Oh. Not entirely. I'm sorry. I'm just going to be blunt and honest here.
Yeah, be real.
Detoxification comes from within. Badan you hanya boleh detox certain level saja. That is that dari pemakanan you. First of all, of course, lemon and one more thing in the morning is really important. And then number two is fiber. If you don't eat enough fiber and sayur, right, badan you tak boleh detox. And most of the detox are, I would say, supplements out there is ada campuran sayur, right? But why you want to eat something is processed, yang bukan 100%. You can eat sayur. Eat sayur.
Everybody suka makan sayur.
Tak suka makan sayur, boleh blend and then put a little bit of like...
Campus is good. It's got a little bit of flavoring. Then you can just drink it.
Yeah. And then of course, what you need to do, detoxification dua cara. One is from your sweat. Number two is really important, which is from your liver. Okay, kalau liver you tak sihat, badan you tak boleh detox properly. So how you detox properly via liver? Bila you bangun, air suam dan juga lemon. Kalau boleh minum veggie smoothie, go for veggie smoothie. Okay, that will alkalize your body. It's really important. Take your vitamin B. This is important also for liver detoxifications in the morning. Make sure your multivitamin is on point and start your day with 30 grams of protein. Okay, bukan start your morning dengan nasi lemak, minum goreng, minum nasi lemak, carbohydrates and sugar people. Okay, no! So that's how you detox your body properly.
Yeah.
Protein. When I say protein, tak kisahlah. You boleh makan telur,
you boleh
makan tuna, anything. There's going to be wasted. Banyak je local food yang penuh dan kaya dengan sumber protein. And then, I would say air dengan banyak.
Memang kena minum air dengan banyak. That's it. Macam itulah dia helps to detox your body and everything. Go to the toilet and pee and everything. Sweat when you work out, it helps to detox.
If your liver tak properly functioning, tak boleh detox properly. Yes, tak bakal.
Soalan, cuba jerit. Ya, bilang kan. Ya,
silakan.
Soalan
dia. Masih. I tak boleh. So benda ni semua you kena monitor and you kena tengok badan you respond macam mana. brown rice, kurangkan sikit white rice. If you nak makan basmati, it's fine.
Yeah,
but be careful with bread. Because certain people, they akan bloat dengan bread. And same goes to certain protein as well. Walaupun kita kurus, tak semestinya kita boleh makan semua protein. Some people, their reactions towards, I would say chicken, tak okay. So, tengok ikan or chicken.
Yep.
Baik. Faham tak? 1A, 1C, 20, whatever. Ha, kan? Thank you.
drive ke, mak ke, atuk ke, dengan fitness, ada fitness ke orang. Just do what you can. Focus on yourself. Progress at your own pace. It's not about comparing.